Namaste. We have learnt the Asamyuta and Samyukta Hastas. That is, we know the names and we know the gestures. Now we will learn the usage or the Viniyoga. Now let me tell you from before that the Abhinaya Darpan was written around the 3rd century AD. Our dance, Kathak, has been a living art form which has changed. Now, there are many classical dance forms in our country which were lost or which had decayed and degenerated. And so, when scholars and artists were trying to reconstruct their dance form, they had to follow a certain authoritative text. And so many of them followed the Abhinaya Darpan word for word. Now, since our dance form has had a living tradition and we have had many artists and gurus contributing, sometimes the exact description of the usage of a certain Hasta does not fit in with our dance idiom. But we will try to discover the similarity between the usage described in the Abhinaya Darpan and that which exists in our dance form as it is practiced. First, we will begin with Pataka Hasta. Now, the first usage, as the Abhinaya Darpan tells us, is natyarambhe, or in the beginning of a dance drama. Now, in Kathak, you know that we generally use the arala hasta. So, from the very beginning, when we enter with the arala hasta. But we will try to discover whether we can find any similarity. Let us hear the shloka, or rather the beginning of the shloka, which describes the Viniyoga or the usage of the Pataka Hasta.
Natyarambhe Vare Vahe Vane vastu nishedhane.
So, natyarambhe, if we think of Kathak dance dramas or even Kathak dance, we generally begin with this. But again, if we think of Gat Bhava, when taking the palta, we use the Pataka Hasta. Like from here, we are turning. So, the Pataka Hasta does come in. Okay? Then, Vari Vahe, that which carries water, a cloud. Now, when showing a cloud, we definitely do use the Pataka Hasta.
Good. Arna.
Next is Vane. That is when we are showing the forest or other, going towards a forest, entering a forest.
Re pa ma re ma ga ni sa re. Re ma ba da ma re ma ga ni ni sa.
Then vastu nishedhane. When we say no. Now this is also very commonly used in life, and in dance it is very stylized, and generally when Krishna is coming and teasing the gopis, they always say no using the pataka hasta. So with the Viniyoga.
Tanana, 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 dananana, din.
So these are four usages of the pataka hasta. Natyarambhe, then varivahe, vane, vastu, nishedhane. Then let us hear the next line of the shloka.
Kuchasthale nishayancha nadyam maramandale.
So when we are showing the breath, this is not very commonly used in Kathak. Then when we are showing night, so actually how can you show night? We can just show the darkness, and the fact that the darkness is so sort of dense that we are trying to grope and find our way. So then a river, we are showing the waves. Here too the pataka hasta is used. And amaramandal is when we are showing the heavens. So let us use the pataka hasta in the first two lines of the shloka. And you can use your own gestures. You don't have to necessarily do what I am doing. Try to use your own imagination, but use the pataka hasta. So starting with Natyarambhe.
Natyarambhe varivahe vane vastu nishedhane kuchasthale nishayancha nadyam amaramandale.
Then again, pataka hasta has other Viniyogas, usages. Let us hear what the Abhinaya Darpan tells us.
Turange khandane vayau shayane gamanodyame.
So turanga is a horse. Now in Kathak we don't generally show a horse with pataka hasta, but we can show that we are patting a horse, okay? But khandan, definitely we use in Kathak. Khandan is when we are cutting something, as when you are in a battle, when you are fighting, when you are cutting a tree, a human being also. So let's try to do khandan with Pataka Hasta.
Mama pa, mama pa, mama pa sa sa, mama pa sa sa re.
Next is
Vayo.
Breeze. The gentle breeze. Then we come to
Shayani.
When we are sleeping, lying down. And when we are
Gamanodhyame,
preparing to go outside. So these represent our feet. Again, we can show the road that we are going to take. So let us do it with the shloka.
Turange khandane vayau shayane gamano dhyame.
Again, a few more usages.
Pratape.
Pratap, when we are showing force or our power. Pratape, then
prasadecha.
This hand we use very often when we are showing any deity, any god. Prasadecha.
Chandrikayang.
Chandrikayang. That is the moon, the body of the moon. The circular moon. And Ghanatapi, when it is very hot. So we'll do this line with the mudras, the shloka now.
Pratape cha prasade cha chandrikaya ghanatape.
Then the next few usages, for that we'll hear the next line.
Kavat patane.
When we are opening the door, okay? We can use
pa ma ga ma ga ni sa re ga ga re re ma pa dha ma pa sa.
If somebody
dha
is
pa ga re sa
trying to stop you, your
re pa ga re ga re ni sa re ga ma re ma dha dha ni ni pa sa ni pa re ma dha pa ga ni sa re pa pa ga ni sa re ga ga ma.
Then again
sapta vibhakti arthe.
So sapta vibhakti we don't use in Kathak, because generally the language used in Kathak is Hindi, Urdu, or very simple form of Sanskrit in which the declensions and the various cases are not used. So this we will not even try because it is not used.
Taranga.
Taranga, waves. Okay, these are then different types of waves. So let us try and use our imagination to show different types of waves with the Pataka Hasta.
re pa ga re re ma ni dha ma pa sa ni pa ni sa ma pa ni re ma pa sa re ga re sa re pa ga ga re ga sa sa re ga ma re ma da 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 ni 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 ba sa pa ga re pa ga re ga re ni sa re ga ma.
Now, water has a very important role in Kathak presentations because we know that Krishna is always hanging around near the Yamuna and all the gopis come to the water side, and so we have many ways in which we show waves, and the pataka hand is often used. The next few usages of the pataka hasta, as the Abhinaya Darpan tells us, let us hear the shloka first.
Vithi pravesh bhaveh api samatve cha angarag ke.
Now, entering a winding road, say maybe in a garden.
Ga 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 ma ga ma dha ni sa re ma ma ga re ga 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 ma dha ma ga ma ga ma dha ga re ma pa ni sa ni pa re ma dha pa ga sa.
Then samatva, we don't use it in a variety of ways, but angarag is when we are adorning ourselves. Then we use pataka, and the usage of pataka and also the variations of angarag are beautiful. So let's try and do angarag in various ways.
Ni sa da ni sa ni pa ma pa ga ma ni 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 sa ni sa re sa re ni sa da da ni pa ni re ba ma ba sa ni ga ga ma ni 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 sa.
We come to the next few usages of pataka. Let us hear the shlok again. The next line now.
Atmarthe shapathe chapi tushnim bhava nidarshane.
So, when we are showing ourselves, atmarthe, shapathe, when we are taking an oath, then when we are asking somebody, keep quiet. Okay. The next few usages now.
Taal patre cha khete cha dravyadi sparshane.
Talapatre is, you know, the talpatra was used to write. So this is the talpatra in which we are writing. Then khete is a stick. Now we generally don't use this mudra for a stick in Kathak, but to touch various things. So like, for instance, I'm touching you or touching something, then we use pataka. The next series of usages, let us hear the shlok and then try to follow it.
Ashirvad kriyayayancha nripasreshthasya bhavane tatra tatreti vachane sindhauch sukriti krame.
So, we come to the next word, which is
Ashirvad.
When the gods bless us, or when we are blessing someone, if somebody touches our feet, or if somebody bows down to us, Ashirvad, we use this. Then,
Nripasrishthasya Bhavani.
For a king, like a king wears an armlet or the crown, or maybe just thinking that I'm a great king. Then again,
Tatra Tatreti.
When we are showing different things or different persons, then we are using, this is a common usage of Pataka in Kathak.
Vachane.
To say something. Generally in Vachan we use this, but again we can say that, okay, like we can of course use this mudra.
Sindho.
The sea. Here we are showing the waves again. And
Sukriti.
A good deed. A good deed can be shown in this way. But again, in Kathak, we also show it with the Hamsasya Mudra. Which this is also symbolic of good in Kathak and is used more often. So, the entire shloka, at least this line now.
Sambodhane puro gehpi khadgaru
So, Sambodhane is when I'm addressing someone. Then, when I'm speaking of those who have gone before me, like they are there already, then using the kharga. And finally, two or three more usages named by the Abhinaya Darpan, which are not that commonly used in Kathak. Let us hear them.
Mase Sangvatsare Varshadine Sammarjane Tatha.
Here, for month or year, we generally don't show it with the Pataka Hasta, and I don't know, I can't think of any special place in our dance form where we are showing cleaning. But you're like, generally, we are always either decorating by sort of strewing flowers or putting garlands. So we generally don't go into actually cleaning a place. So Sammarjan also does not come in. So we won't work on the usages of these mudras. And the last line of this set of verses.
Evam arteshu yojyante pataka hasta bhavana.
Now, we were comparing the usage of the Pataka Mudra in Kathak with that which has been described in the Abhinaya Darpan. I told you before that there are many classical dance forms which were lost or which had fallen into decay. So when they were trying to reconstruct their dance, they followed the Abhinaya Darpan verbatim, but we have not. And another important feature to notice is that in many dance forms, the pataka is done, you know, with a lot of stiffness in the fingers. And, you know, like when you're doing Sambodhan or Angarag. But in Kathak, we use natural mudras. So sometimes when we are using the pataka mudra, then also it's not that the fingers are always joined. Kathak Abhinaya is very soft, you know, our angik is very soft and very delicate.
Natyarambhe Varivahe Vane Vastu Nishedhane Kuchasthale Nishayancha Nadhyama Amara Mandale Torange Khandane Vayo Shayane Gamano Dhyame Pratape cha prasade cha chandrikaya ghanatape kavat patne sapta vibhakti arthe Taranga ke Vithi pravesh bhavahapi Samatve cha angarag ke Atma arthe Shapate Chapi Toshne Bhav Nidarshane Talpatre Cha Khete Cha Dravyadi Sparshane Tatha Ashirvad Kriyayancha Nripa Shrestasya Bhavane Tatra Tatreti Vachane Sindhocha Sukriti Krame Sambodhane Purogepi Khadgarupasya Dharane Maase Sangvatsare Varshadine Sammarjane Tatha Evam artheshu yujyante patak hastabhavana.
So do practice and do remember all the hastas that you have learnt, and I wish you all the best. We will continue with the hastas in the next lesson. Thank you.